Next topic is circulatory pathways. So come to the lower organism like sponges. Canal system is present for the digestion, respiration and circulation. Whereas cnidarian flatworms, the gastrovascular system is present through which the food or the gases will be exchanged and transported. And roundworm circulatory system is absent, pseudocoelom is present. Through that coelomic fluid only transportation, excretion, all those will be takes place. Now come to the circulatory system, it is two types. Open type of circulatory system, closed type of circulatory system. In open type of circulatory system, blood is pumped by the heart, which is entering to the large blood vessels and open space that is called the sinus. From that sinus through the veins, it is re-entering to the heart. And here, that whatever the pumped fluid is present, that is called the hemolymph. Lymph is formed at the extracellular fluid and blood will be mixed and forming the hemolymph, which is completely filled in the coelom. So, the organs which are present in the coelom bathed in that fluid. That means they are floated on that fluid. And what is the example for here? Open type of circulatory system is arthropoda, non-cephalopods of molluscans, echinodermata, hemichordates, urochordates. So these are the example for the open type of circulatory system. Next, come to the closed type of circulatory system. Here blood, heart is pumping the blood which is entering to the blood vessels like arteries and veins, blood capillaries, and next from that it is again entering to the heart. Here more pressurely it is pumping. Pressure requirement is morely present here. And the closed type of circulatory system is annelida, cephalopods, cephalochordates and chordates. Now come to the vertebrate circulatory system. Two-chambered heart is present in the fishes. So that's why fish heart is called the venous heart or the pulmonary heart. Because here venous heart, it is collecting the blood from the venous and reaching to the heart. From the heart, it reaches to the gills. That's why we are calling it is a venous heart or the branchial heart. And in amphibians, three-chambered heart is present. Frog, for example, if you are taken, how many chambers are present? Three. And remaining reptiles, if you are considered incomplete four-chambered. Here ventricle is not completely divided, that's why incomplete four chamber we see in reptilians. Exception is crocodile. So here three chambered, incomplete four chambered. The circulation is incomplete double circulation. Which type of circulation is present? Incomplete double circulation. So complete four chambered heart is present in crocodiles, birds and mammals. So here right is for deoxygenated, left is for the oxygenated blood, and all here aortic arches are present to supply the blood to the body, and completely artery and ventricles are divided, and complete double circulation will be takes place in the crocodiles, aves and mammals. Two chambered heart is seeing in the fishes, three chamber is amphibians, incomplete four chambers reptiles, and here incomplete double circulation, and sinus venosus is present, conus atriosus is present in the amphibians, sinus venosus is absent and conus atriosus is present here, and here no sinus venosus, no conus atriosus, only aortic arches are present in the four chambered heart. Here incomplete double circulation, here it is a complete double circulation.